الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أسعد الأنبياء والمرسلين، نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، ومن دعا بدعوته واستنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين. وبعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I would love to summarize today's khutbah, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards the Sheikh in abundance. This is our khutbah number 81 in this masjid. May Allah accept it from us. The topic, as announced, is love of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Sheikh will be the one to give us a talk tomorrow, inshallah. After Maghrib, between Maghrib and Isha, there will be a muhadara as usual. This month it's going to be tomorrow, inshallah. So you are all invited. And tomorrow's topic will be on the trials of the end times. Between Tinunk and Shenzamani, inshallah, Malam Zaymana Magana Bobe, Asakani Maghriba da Isha, Muna Gayetan Kowa da Kowa, one day Kena Yasandra da Wanda Bayana. So the khutbah is on the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You can categorize his love into two, into true and false. False in the sense that some people may claim that they love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but it's just a matter of the lips. It stays on the lips. It's not deep inside the heart. So this I call it false. When I say true, it means by you loving the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is deep inside your heart, which is the valid type of love. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is to be loved, and this is a prerequisite of your belief. Your faith will not be complete when you do not love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said in hadith of Anas and other companions, hadith that is agreed upon by Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, one of you will not believe, or the faith of one of you will not be complete until I am the most beloved to you than your wealth and your family and the entire mankind. Your love for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has to supersede any other form of love for mankind. And one day Umar bin al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that, O Prophet, I love you wholeheartedly, but the love I have for myself supersede the love I have for you. That means I love you, but I love myself much more. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him that your faith is incomplete, O Umar. Your faith will only be complete when my love in your heart supersedes any form of love you have for any other mankind, even yourself. So then Umar radiallahu anhu said, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that, O you Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I love you more than I love myself. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him that, it is now, O Umar. So it's now that your belief is complete and the love completes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al Imran that, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Allah said that, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ, say to them that if truly you will love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَاتَّبِعُونِي, then follow me, يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will then love you, وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ, and he will forgive your sins, وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ رَحِيمٌ, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving and merciful. So you see, you cannot just claim that you love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam without you loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your belief in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is attached to the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you obey the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is as good as you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ. When you obey the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it means you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet was sent to explain to us the message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The message is contained in the glorious Quran, and the authentic ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explains the Quran better for us. So this is what it means to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And part of the signs that you love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is that whatever he gives, you take. وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Whatever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives you, you take it. And whatever he forbids, you should refrain from it. This is to express your love for him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he says this is what is to be done, you go straight, you practice it, you do it. When he said don't do this, you avoid it, you refrain from it. This is true love. If your love for him is true, then you will obey him. For the one who loves, إِنَّ الْمُحِبَّ لِمَنْ يُحِبُّ مُطِيعُ. You will be obedient to the one you love, if really you love that person. So the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nisa, as part of the signs that you love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is to make sure that all your judgment, whatever you judge, should be in alignment with the teaching of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَضَيْتَ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. Allah swore that the hypocrites will not believe until they judge in between them, the dispute that happens between them with the consent or the judgment of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Whatever he says on that, it's the final. And then aside this, they should not have any form of discomfort in their hearts. They should just submit, absolute submission. This is a sign that you love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is not part of the signs of the love for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to celebrate his birthday. Malam just told us that there are contradictions as to which day he was born, but there was no contradiction that he sallallahu alaihi wasallam died on the 12th of Rabi'ul Awwal. But as for the day he was born, there are contradictions, there are sayings, but if you are to gather, the most authentic is that he was born on the 9th of Rabi'ul Awwal. So you see, it's not in his love that you celebrate that. He has never celebrated, neither did his companions, radiallahu anhum. So whatever the Prophet say we should do is what we should abide by. Whatever form of act that you have that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did, then you should try as much as possible to practice that. And you should not be relying on ahadith, the sayings that are inauthentic. You cannot take those sayings as terms of reference. You only reference with ahadith that are authentic. So this is the whole summary of the khutbah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us aright. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease our affairs. May He subhanahu wa ta'ala make our country peaceful. The forms of insecurities we are facing, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring us solution. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our livelihood easy. This is not difficult by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He can do it. We should just pray harder, and then change our attitude towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and towards our brothers. We should treat people the way we want to be treated. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على النبي الكريم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.